Hey guys, what's going on? It's Max, and I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. And I am so sorry. I am supremely under the weather, so you guys are just gonna have to deal with my very sick voice for right now. I'm just gonna try to make this video and then go lay down for a couple of hours. Other than that, what you guys are watching in the background is just some more Overwatch gameplay. It's been my game of choice for the past, I want to say, couple of months. There hasn't really been anything out that's captivated my attention as much as Overwatch. And with that being said, Overwatch Season 2 for the competitive season is coming out soon, and I'm super stoked for it. It's about time they made some damn changes. Season 1 was great, don't get me wrong, but I felt like the ranking system was a little off, specifically because they had a ranking system from between 1 or 0. You can actually reach rank 0 all the way up to rank 100, and I don't think I've seen a rank 100. I've seen some people up there, some PC players between rank 70 and rank 80, some people kind of knocking up those high levels up there. On console though, it was pretty much a staple to see people around rank 60 to rank 70 as their high, and even that for, and I know some of the Overwatch devs have talked about it, that is like what they would consider crazy great Overwatch players, which for me felt like just a regular pub match. I'm gonna be quite honest, we would get into games and there would sometimes be people there that just didn't understand the entire throw of the game. You get a lot of people who think that their way is the best way, and then you had a lot of people out there who just thought that, you know, I main this character and that's it. Even though everybody knows when you play competitive Overwatch, there has to be a specific balance between support players, defense players, offense players, and your tanks. And there's been multiple times where I've gotten into a game where no one wants to play those players, so I forced myself to get better or be better with a support class character, whether that be a tank or whether that be a healer. Everybody knows I like to, as my main tank, I like to use Reinhardt. In the gameplay you guys are watching, I'm using Zarya because it's the off season and I want to start getting better with some of these other characters. So I'm forcing myself to learn and get better and be better and see how well it's going to help my team in the long run. All of that being said, season 2, I'm so happy that they're getting rid of that damn coin flip. If you guys haven't played Overwatch, it's basically when you're playing a competitive match online, if you guys end up getting the same score, you end up in a draw, you have this thing called a sudden death mode where you'll go and basically the first person to get to the first point, or it's the first, whether you can hold them off or whether you can attack, or whether you can get the payload to a specific spot, like the first point in the spot, that team would win. And it's a very unfair advantage to either the attacking or the defending team depending on the map. Like Temple of Anubis, it was very unfair to the attacking team because everybody knows that first point is one of the hardest points to get into. Same thing with the second point because they're just so closed off. There's only so many routes that you can take and they're very easy to defend. I'm so happy they're getting rid of that and that they're actually divvying out people, you know, draws for the entire match, and the way that the match layouts are going to be, the time to execute is going to be a little bit different as well. There's some character buffs and debuffs as well that are going to pop up in season 2, but I'm looking forward more to the layout of the actual games. And I know that Blizzard and the devs over there have kind of said that, you know, draws, they're hoping that draws will be a rare occurrence, and I don't think that's the case. I think it's going to get to the point where draws are going to be a pretty similar occurrence, especially because of the new ranking system that they've implemented, which I'm a much bigger fan of anyway. Everybody knows that if you've been on Reddit or if you've been on the forums for Blizzard or for anything else, the ranking system for Overwatch is so just, it doesn't make any sense, man. You would win maybe about 3-4 games, right? And then you would level up an entire rank. And let me tell you, I would be ecstatic if I could get up another rank. And then I would lose a game, and it didn't matter whether you lost by like a million points or you, like, it was really a fight to the finish and you lost. You would still lose so much competitive XP. It was staggering. I have went down 4 levels in one night just due to like 2 or 3 losses, and it has killed me. It killed motivation for me to go and play Overwatch to the point where there were nights where I just wasn't feeling it, man. I just didn't want to play. I didn't want to put myself through the fact that there were going to be losses, because it's not just me who I have to worry about, it's my other teammates as well. So I'm so happy that the ranking system has changed. I don't know what the spread is going to look like, because, you know, it's to the point where if your teammates or if your friends are a certain level above you or below you, they can't play with you. So I don't know how that's going to affect me and my friends, because I know sometimes we don't run on the same schedule, but I'd like to see a decent enough spread where I can still play with my friends, but not so wide as to get those people. And I saw them in season one, you'd get in a match with rank 65 and there's a rank 40 sitting there. And I'm wondering to myself, why? Why are you here? What do you gain from this? Obvious it's for the growth and for the XP, but I mean... It dulls the experience, especially when they're on our team and they don't have an understanding of the game. They don't understand what characters work well with other characters, and they don't understand how to use their ults at the proper time, how to communicate effectively, all the different flank routes, and they don't understand the counters. There's a lot of things that can go into Overwatch. A simple play can make the game. And I've seen it happen time and time again. One simple ult or just an entire team working together in those final seconds. I have won matches in those final seconds. I have won matches in overtime time and time again. Matches that would last almost like 20 minutes, 30 minutes long. Just ridiculously long Overwatch matches because we're so evenly matched up. And it all comes down to that last alt or how appropriate you move or what you're planning on doing next. How well you read your opponents. So I'm looking forward to those changes in Season 2 that's going to make things a lot easier, like the ranking system and the sudden death system and everything else that comes with Overwatch Season 2. If you guys are playing Overwatch, let me know in the comment section below. For the next couple of days, it's going to be this Overwatch video, which I'm going to upload right after I complete it. And then I do believe the Battlefield 1 beta is out, so we're going to try some Battlefield 1. I am excited. I have that one pre-ordered, the Deluxe Edition or whatever the hell it's called, that the DICE called it, the one that came with the season pass. I have that one pre-ordered, so this will be the telltale of whether I go ahead and drop the money and pick it up too. But I hope you guys will stay along for the ride. As always, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I am off like a prom dress, and I'll see you in the next one.